The following content covers the updates added to Fortify on Demand version 21.1. The following updates have been made to the Fortify on Demand API. The API now supports automated dynamic web services scans utilizing OpenAPI and Postman files. Dynamic scan setup endpoints have been updated for configuring automated dynamic scans. The patch endpoint has been added for uploading an OpenAPI JSON specification or Postman collection. Let's look at configuring the dynamic scan settings for a dynamic web services scan and uploading the web services manifest through the API. This demonstration uses Postman to make the API request. First, make a request to the patch endpoint to upload the web services manifest. In this example, the query parameter web service file type is set to Postman. The collection file is included in the request body. After the collection file has been uploaded, make a request to the put endpoint to configure the dynamic scan settings. In this example, the body parameter web service type is set to Postman collection file. Finally, when you are ready to submit your dynamic assessment, make a request to the post endpoint. If the submission is successful, the scan ID appears in the response. Additional API updates include the scan binary setting do binary scan has been added to the response from the endpoint get static scan setup. The modified start date optional parameter has been added to the endpoints listed here. This allows the results to be filtered to items that have been modified on or after the specified start date. Fortify on Demand now supports the Defense Information Systems Agency Security Technical Implementation Guide versions 4.11 and 5.1. The portal includes the following additions: STIG 4.11 and 5.1 report modules and report templates, STIG 4.11 and 5.1 columns in the issues data export, STIG 4.11 and 5.1 selections in the issue pages grouping and filter lists, STIG 4.11 and 5.1 compliance and security policies, STIG 4.11 and 5.1 information and responses from API endpoints. For the full list of API endpoints, see the release notes. The following updates have been made to the Sonatype integration. The package URL, a Sonatype identifier for an open source component, is now available in Sonatype scan results. The package URL has been added to the open source components pages. Package URL has been added to the response from the endpoint get open source components. Open source components and the payload that are not recognized by Sonatype have been added to the open source components pages. Full recommendation details for an open source issue have been added to API endpoints. For the full list of API endpoints, see the release notes. Your tenant must have previously added a Sonatype Nexus IQ license in the Fortify on Demand portal. Open source issues now have the issue status marked as fixed validated. They have been determined by Sonatype to be non-active vulnerabilities. Fortify on Demand has expanded the Secure Code Warrior training integration to increase training offerings and link to targeted training based on the issue type. Modules are now available in all vulnerability categories supported by Secure Code Warrior. If an issue doesn't map to a module, a link to the closest relevant training is provided. Finally, the following updates have been made to the Tools page. Users can now download the Fortify Security Assistant license on the Tools page. Your tenant must have previously been issued a Security Assistant license. The Tools page now provides a link to the Fortify extension for Visual Studio Code Marketplace page. We hope that you have found this information helpful. Thank you for watching.